everyone. Thank you for joining me today. I'm going to be talking about my cataloguing and storage of my Kia stamps and my red rubber stamps. I wanted something that I could quickly go to see what I had in my stash, which was also a double up so that I didn't double up on stamps. So not only can I see what I've got, I can, if I'm buying new stamps, then I'm not going to run that risk of doubling up. Now, this is not being catalogued so to be in a theme, so I don't have all my Christmas stuff together, and then all my birthday stuff. It is all the way throughout. You could easily, of course, do it where you want to theme it. You would need to probably have a lot more folders, because you would essentially need to have, like, this would be your Christmas folder, this would be your birthday folder. For me, that wasn't really important, because you can, I think, quickly see what stamps you have. So I haven't gone down that road, but I probably in the future, if I wanted to do that, I could quite easily adapt that. Now, for those that are following me, you will see that I do things to be effective. I have not gone to all the trouble and jazzed up these folders. They're a folder for me. I really don't have an interest to make them all jazzy. But, you know, they are folders that you could do that. They have the spine and obviously the edge sides as well. You know, and you could do whatever you wanted to do. For me, it doesn't interest me to do it, so I haven't done it. So they are in their raw form, and you'll see that with a lot of stuff. For me, it's about function. It's not about jazzing up this, but each to their own, I guess. So what I've done is I've created a folder as my index folder, and essentially I have, out of the clear stamps, you get the clear plastic that the stamps are attached to. I'll just grab here one here to show you. So when you get a lot of the clear stamps, they're sort of just in this format here. And so you peel off, they have two sides to them. So one side is going to be clear, which I keep all of those because that's great acetate if you want to, you know, use them on other projects. And then the stamp is attached and then it has what that stamp is. So all that I've done for my clear stamp is I've just taken that sheet that has it listed on there, and then I've just laminated these. So I've put a piece of white sheet behind so that I can use them on the other side. And then all I've done is I've noted, so folder one, and that represents the page. So any of these stamps I will see in folder one on page one. So then I just go to my folder that is named folder one and folder one and page one. And so you can see there are all my stamps. So there's, you know, I want to use that tree. Well, there's that tree. And you, with the clear stamps, you can quite easily see what they represent, even though they are, you know, going to be the opposite in the wording. So I've done that all the way through. So folder one, one, folder one, page two, folder one, page three. I did also start to refer them back to the magazines, because a lot of my free clear stamps have come from magazines. And so I have referred them back to the magazine that they were in. So if I want to take some inspiration from that magazine about what I'm going to create with them, I've got that magazine name on there as well. I haven't gone to the trouble of doing it all the way through. You will notice clear stamps particularly will soak up colour, but that colour doesn't transfer if you clean them each time. So just something, you know, it visually looks like it's dirty, but it's not. So that's really all I've done, is I've just done them in folders. Most of these are all my clear stamps. There are a couple of rubber ones in here. But that's the theme of how I've done mine. So I can quickly just go, and these just sit up on the top of my my craft table. So if I'm looking for a particular sentiment, you know, I'll just keep having a look. I don't know if you're going to be able to see that. It might be reflecting off there. But you can see, and you might go, oh, well, I'll use that sentiment. And so you just go to the relevant folder and the relevant page that it's on. So, again, you know, I've just kept all the acetate sides of that. Now, with I buy a lot of Kazaz stamps, which are the red rubber stamps. And all I did to get the cataloguing done for that was I had old catalogues, and so a lot of what I did was I cut out of the actual catalogue itself and put them in there. Some of them I just went to the Kazaz website and printed them off. I'm actually a Kazaz consultant, and so for me I didn't feel that I was, you know, plagiarising anything. It is for my own use for cataloguing. I'm not, you know, selling it off as Kazaz. It is simply for me to use. But, you know, it is something you do need to consider as copyright when you start to photocopy stuff out of books and whatnot. But, yeah, so, you know, like this set here is in folder 212. So I go to my folder 2 and I just look for page 12. And you can just, you know, they flip over relatively easy. And it just happens to be the end of the page, and there they are. Now, these folders, I bought those online. I can't right off the top of my head think of the company that they were from, but I will find that information and I will put a comment down the bottom or edit somewhere so that you can, you know, what they are through. And three ring or more, these come already in three ring on the actual page itself, far better than using two ring. Two ring tends to slide and slip. I find three ring works really well. And you can buy special folders that these actually go into, but again, it just adds cost, you know. And so a three ring binder from your local stationer is going to do the job, as you can see. So I didn't worry about buying the actual proper folders for them, but they work a treat. You can also do the same thing for your dies, and the page is not clingy. It would obviously be magnetic, but you can do exactly the same for your dies. And you know, you can, instead of having a copy of what the stamp is, you could essentially cut a die cut and have those die cuts there. So again, you would just be flicking through to find what you want and using the catalogue system. So that works for me very well. I have three folders of stamps and one catalogue. You know, you can build upon it, and that's the best thing for me. So I hope this has given you some inspiration to catalogue your stamps or your dies. And thank you for looking.